welcome back to another episode of Pokémon Violet. Let's get started. Before we start, though, I need to go through the Pokédex because I caught some Pokémon and evolved some. None of the Gen 9 stuff, though. Just the older version, the older ones. Yeah. Also, if you're looking for the dolphin or the Wattrel, I found them over here. I was exploring this area and I came across a cave which for Violet has Salandit, Bagon, Gible, Sableye, and Yungoose. And then I was able to do some hunting here too, and some training. And I did get this one, but that's all the further I went there while training. Oh, what am I doing? Fletchender. I think we already did. I caught Hundour. It uses different kinds of cries for communicating with others of its kind and for pursuing its prey. And my female Combi evolved into Vespaquin. It raises grubs in the holes in its body. It secretes pheromones to control Combi. So. And Azurill evolved into Meryl and Azumarill. The oiled fill tail functions as a buoy, so it's fine even in rivers with strong currents. By keeping still and listening intently, it can tell what is in even wild, fast-moving rivers. And Tootle evolved into Drednaw. Drednaw lurks along the shoreline. When prey comes to drink water, Drednaw stretches its neck out and chomps down on them. And Igglybuff evolved into Jigglypuff. If it inflates to sing a lullaby, it can perform longer and cause sure drowsiness in its audience. And I caught Rolla Coley and it evolved into Carpole. It needed one level. Trunks of the surface of this Pokemon's body that have grown old and flaked off have long been used for fuel as an alternative to coal. Due to the coal tar created inside it, the heap of coal on Carcoal's back never falls apart, even when the Pokemon rolls around at high speed. And Mareep did finally evolve into Flaffy. Because of its rubbery, electricity-resistant skin, it can store lots of electricity in its fur. Did I read Mareep? I think so. I caught Crabrawler in that little area. If it loses its pincers, they'll quickly regrow. The pincers are popular ingredients in paella since their shells produce a tasty soup stock. And this is the Salandit. It took forever to find the female version. Only female Salandit can produce gas laden with pheromones. Males entranced by this gas will do whatever the female tells them. It nests in horizontal holes warmed by geothermal heat. Foes who get too close can expect to be pounced on and bitten. I caught Aracuda. It takes down prey by charging into them with its hard pointed jaw, but Aracuda's eyesight is poor, so this tactic has a low success rate. Oh, we learned something new about Aracuda. Its eyesight is poor. I found a Flabébé. This Pokémon likes blue flowers best of all. It floats upward using the power emanating from its flower and bobs along lightly through the air. And I went back and caught that Numel. The flaming magma it stores on the hump on its back is the source of its tremendous power. And I caught Riolu. It has the peculiar power of being able to see emotions such as joy and rage in the form of waves. And I finally caught a Charcadet, but I can't use it yet because it's level 30. Its firepower increases when it's fighting, reaches over 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit. It likes berries that are rich in fat. And like I said, I finally caught my Wattroll. These Pokemon can make their nests on coastal cliffs. The nests have a strange crackling texture and they're a popular delicacy. I caught an Eevee. I caught a female Eevee, actually. Its genetic code is irregular. It may mutate if it is exposed to radiation from element stones. And I found a Dunsparce. You gotta sneak up on it. If spotted, it escapes by burrowing with its tail. It can float just slightly using its wings. And I found a Toxel. Oh, I like that picture. This selfish attention-seeking Pokemon stores poison and electricity in two different sacks inside its body. Oh, we learned something new about Toxel. And I found a Pachirisu. A pair may be seen rubbing their cheek pouches together in an effort to share stored electricity. And I caught the Swablu. It can't relax if it or its surroundings are not clean. It wipes off dirt with its wings. I found a Murkrow too. If spotted, it will lure an unwary person into chasing it, then leaves the pursuer on mountain trails. And I found a Toad Skull. It's near, the place I found it was just across the river from the West Gate. Though it looks like tentacle, Toad Skull is a completely different species. Its legs may be thin, but it can run at a speed of 30 miles per hour. I did find a Scyther, but I couldn't catch it, and it was in that same area. Here's the Bagon. It's a belief that it will be able to fly one day is apparently the influence of information carried in its genes. I really do want that Pokemon. And I caught a Bombardier. Bombardier uses the apron on its chest to bundle up food, which it carries back to its nest. It enjoys dropping things that make loud noises. I think I read that one. And I caught the dolphin Pokemon. I think I said that. Its water ring is made from seawater mixed with a sticky fluid that Finizen secretes from its blowhole. Oh yeah, and Sableye. Materials from gems it has eaten float to the surface of its body and can form an infinite number of patterns among individuals. Ooh, we learned something new about Sableye. I also caught Shellder. Clamping on to an opponent reveals its vulnerable part, so it uses this move only as a last resort. And Quillfish. Experienced fishers say they try to catch Quillfish in the brief moment that these Pokémon become defenseless just after launching poisonous spikes. Love Disc. During the spawning season, countless Lovedis congregate at coral reefs, turning the waters pink. Roughlet, I found one. With its sharp claws, this Pokemon pierces its prey and then pecks it at him. Although it also consumes berries, it's a carnivore at heart. Alright, and that was it. I know that they are boring. You can always skip them too. So. Probably go here and then here. Oh, I will have lots of catching to do. Hey, new kid, I know what's up around here. Let me take a look at your Pokemon for you. Okay, that was legit hilarious. I already caught you. Yeah, I bought more Pokeballs too. Females are fussier than the males. If another creature dirties a female Rookidee's wings, it'll peck the offender relentlessly in a burning rage. Okay, so females are aggressive. The expansion and contraction of its muscles generate electricity. Its fur glows when it's in trouble. using its tail like a spring, it keeps its heart beating by bouncing constantly. If it stops, it dies. How tragic. So if you fall down, you can go through here. Okay. It's that Jigglypuff. I'll have to explore more later. Look! Open. Okay, now I know where to go. Hey, Anna. So from what I can gather, the Stony Cliff Titan likes to lurk somewhere in this rocky area. I had to look around, but I couldn't find any trace of it. Maybe it's way up high in a cliff or something? Nah, that's impossible. I don't think it'd be hiding somewhere that tricky, so don't go falling off any cliffs or anything trying to search it out somewhere too strange. Maybe just give your map app a look if you're feeling stumped. Pretty handy. Go away, Rookity, I don't have time for you. be close. This Pokémon lives on sheer cliffs. It sidesteps opponents' attacks, then lunges for their weak spots with its claws. 174 pounds? Jeez. And it doesn't evolve. Oh, I found it. Well, actually, it's a rock. Let's train it. Heal. Wah! That went right through him. The Titan Cross began eating something. Anna, you found it? And that thing's the Stony Cliff Titan? No claw has got any business being that big. Is it gonna be even stronger now after eating those herbs? Let's watch ourselves, Anna. Well, this is looking a little rough. Shelter, let's serve up a helping of defeat on the half shell. Who's in a half shell? It's just a fist coming out. Thank you. Look at my little buddy coming through like a champ. But these Titan Pokemon are yeesh. I sure don't like having something so tough out to get me. I bet somewhere in there, there's more of that Herba Mystica the Titan was eating. Quick, let's have a look around before it comes back. If we're lucky, there'll be another herb here. I knew it! It really is here. This is one of the herbs, make no mistake. Sweet Herb Mystica. We did it! Thanks, Anna! Now then, let's see. What does the book have to say? It says here that the sweet herb Mystica is good for gut health and that it helps aid digestion. It says it's great for stomach aches, too, or when you want to stimulate the old appetite. If I can just slip this into a tasty sandwich and get him to eat some. Well, what are we waiting for, Anna? It's time to dig in. Let me whip something up for us. Yeet-hi-yet-ha-watcha! And Bob's your uncle. Here you go, my special whimsical herb-filled super sandwich. And it comes with a side of Titan Badge, as a token of my gratitude, of course. Fine, here you go. Is it trying to say thanks or something? Well, good thing I made extra. You're helping me out a whole bunch with the hard stuff, so it's only fair you get more. I definitely, absolutely did not make extra so that Maridon could have a sandwich, okay? Yay, you'll be able to dash now. Did it grow stronger again? Man, these Herba Mystica really do pack a punch, don't they? I mean, they better, or else I'm really up the creek. Don't you dare touch that! That isn't for you! Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have shouted like that. I guess I should at least tell you the full story, Anna. Come on out, bud. This is my boss, Stiff. My partner. I'm guessing this is the evolution of the puppy I have. Here you go, bud. Eat up. This sandwich should help you feel better. Oh, the feels! Slowly now. Take your time. Small bites are fine. Just chew nice and slow. My buddy here was hurt pretty bad a while ago. Real bad, in fact. He never really recovered. Potions and things don't work. Nothing seems to help. Not potions, not Pokémon centers, nothing. My boss stiff here is the only thing in the world I care about. The only thing. So I promised that I'd make him better. Whatever it takes. I searched online, I read books, I looked all over and tried every cure and remedy I could find. But nothing really worked. I'd almost given up hope. That's when I found out about the Herba Mystica. That book. What is it? I found it in my dad's lab. Herba Mystica. Area Zero was home to wondrous herbs that instantly impart vigor when eaten. We dubbed them Herba Mystica and attempted to grow some in areas around Paldea. However, before we could harvest, the herbs were eaten by Pokémon, which in turn grew large and strong. We call these Titan Pokémon. It's this book full of crazy stories and legends and things. Stuff nobody'd usually believe. But I believe it. I think what it says is true. And according to this book, eating all five Herba Mystica can cure anything that ails you. Case in point, Mabostiff's paws were cold as ice before he ate that last herb. But they've warmed up a little now. I'm sure they have. Oh, you done eating, bud? Hey, Mabostiff, can you see? Are your eyes open? Yes, I did it! It's been so long since he was able to open his eyes. I was so worried. Oh man, I'm so glad. Aw, look at him. Those fiery orange little eyes. Hard to even tell if they're open or not, but I know the difference. The power of these herbs is amazing. I knew the book wasn't lying. I'm gonna bring my Mabostiff back to full health. I swear it. Yeah, so that's my story. Three herbs to go. Let's find them together. Oh, the feels. My emotions. Pokémon like to toy with your emotions now. And I'm gonna help him find the herbs to cure his pup, his dog. Hello, Anna. This is Turo. I detect that Maridon has regained more of its original power. It seems it will now be able to dash at high speeds while you're riding upon it. By pressing the left stick, but watch out for trees when dashing. If you strike a tree while dashing, Pokemon lurking among the branches will fall down, allowing you to battle them. Well, that just makes people want to do it on purpose. I am relying on you to continue taking good care of Maridon. Ugh. There's another shark deck around here somewhere. I don't see it. What's that? Oh! That is a Growlithe. Thank you. very friendly and faithful to people. It will try to repel enemies by barking and biting. At least this is more of a level where I can train. Blocking the road, Skiddo! I'm doing the treasure hunt too, and no fresh-faced kid is gonna beat me. Aren't you a little old to be going to school? Oh, we gotta change. That's how you battle. I'm sure you'll be able to find your treasure. You battle really good. An Oricario. Gosh darn it. Alright, I caught the other form of Oricario. This form of Oricario has sipped red nectar. It whips up blazing flames as it moves to the steps of its passionate dance. Later, Paulson. Now I want to get to this over here. Well, this is where I'm going to end this episode, so leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any more videos coming your way, because there is more. So, we'll see you next episode.